Well, Mayor Goertzen, here we sit within days of the end of your term as mayor of Steinbach, and wanted to go back and take a look at your political career to this point in life, and wondered, when did you first begin to take an interest in politics?
Well, I grew up in a political family. My dad was a municipal councillor from early on in my life, and so it was a part of my life all throughout, being a young person, being a young adult, and so it's been a permanent structure in my life in general. So it's not something that has come about to me. It's just been there for me as second nature in a way.
What got you interested in running for Steinbach City Council in 2002?
Well, I know certainly in my 20s, when I moved back to Steinbach from my education and working in Montreal, I really loved Steinbach. And I wanted Steinbach to continue to grow and evolve and become the city that it could be. And so back then I decided, well, I had people encouraging me to run for council. And as a small business owner, I felt, okay, it was an appropriate time. And I did just that and was able to contribute for 4 years as a city councillor.
So do you remember those first years on council? What were they like getting into this sort of new area of service?
Well, it was a large learning curve for me. You know, when you go from a business to a city council, it's a different can of worms that you have to deal with. And being a young person on council, also there was a lot of history that you had to learn, a lot of reasons why policy is the way it is. And so it was a great time to learn some of the history, learn how things function as a government, and I have to give a lot of credit to Mayor Les Magnuson at the time that he gave me a portfolio of land use and planning, which allowed me to learn as we went along and allowed me to certainly have influence over policy even as a young councillor.
2006, and Mayor Les Magnuson's not running for re-election. Was it a big decision for you to make that next step?
Absolutely. You know, when that was transpiring, I was 31 years old, and for Steinbach to elect someone who was 31 or 32 at that time would have been unusual. But the timing seemed right. I had a lot of people encouraging me, and I knew I had something to offer for the city, and so I made the plunge. My wife said, okay, go for it, and we did just that, and it worked out.
Have you achieved most of the goals that you set out when you ran for mayor for the first time?
Well, your goals evolve over your time period in council, but certainly I'll tell you, in my office I have a plaque that has every single promise or goal that I had when I was running for council or running for mayor back in 2006. They were on there for 12 years on my wall to remind me of where I wanted to go, where we wanted to bring the city. And when I look back and I read those probably about a year back, I looked at them and I said, you know, each one of these has been achieved to a greater or some lesser degree, and I felt very satisfied to see that that actually happen over a 12-year period, not just a 4-year period. You make many decisions as a mayor, and yes, absolutely, I've had a number of things that have been disappointing and a number of things that have been surprising in the disappointment that you actually achieve something else. But certainly, whenever you're making decisions, whether it's land use decisions, whether it's major capital expenditures and you're trying to bring the public along, or you have a council that has maybe differing viewpoints among them, you end up with some things that don't get achieved as you thought. But at the same time, the discussion is important, the bringing ideas together is important, and so in the end you feel as though there's something achieved, even if you didn't achieve that ultimate goal of maybe building this specific item or making this policy change.
In private life, you're a business owner. You frequently said that running a business is very different from being a mayor. Can you give us some examples of those differences?
Well, in a business, you're completely in charge. It's your money, and it's your decisions. As mayor, you are here as a trustee of the public, and so you're here on behalf of the public. You're here not with your own money, but with everybody's money, and you have to be extra careful, extra cautious, and make decisions differently than you do as a business person. You also deal with 6 other council members, and those decisions are made as a collective group, and that's what makes us strong as a municipal government. But it also makes things different than a business because it's democratic. It's not dictated by one person. So the mayor really has an important role to bring those people together, 6 people with possibly very differing views, and find those compromises and find those ways to achieve the goals that you want to achieve, to think long term, and yet reflect the needs that the public sees and expresses.
Now that you're stepping down as a mayor, what has it been like to watch the current race unfold?
Well, anyone involved in politics, and they say politics is a bit of a disease, and so it's hard to get rid of it. And so you watch it like you watch sports, and you certainly are. It's very interesting to see the different twists and turns and what people have to say. You know, it's really encouraging to see so many people wanting to be involved in municipal government. We have a great city. We have great opportunities. We have people who want to see additional changes. We want to see people moving the city forward. It's really encouraging.
Any surprises during the campaign?
Oh, there's always surprises. Every day you open up your online news, or you open up the newspaper, and you see very, very much things that are transforming and transpiring as you speak, and they're interesting. You know, during elections, people say things they think will make a difference. They make decisions that they feel are appropriate at the time. When it comes to governing, it's a little bit different than campaigning, and I look forward to seeing that transition go from politics to actually policy.
Finally, many people feel politics will again be a part of your future at some point, but what's ahead for you?
First and foremost, I'm imminently waiting for a new child to be included in our family. So our third child is on its way in the next week or two, or we're not sure when exactly, but I'm really looking forward to that. Second of all, I do have my business that I do want to spend some time at, and politics is in my blood. I do enjoy it. And so whether it's involved in helping other municipalities function well as groups or as governing bodies, or something else in the future, I'm not sure, but I do know for now I'm here to serve the community in other ways and certainly to be with my family.
I should just ask a one last question, and that's, you've guided the city for 12 years and led council, so any advice you'd like to share?
Well, I think not being too quick to judge certain situations or issues or policies, find out the background. Find out how it can affect people in a positive or negative way, and make a decision that includes everybody, not just a few people. Make sure everyone on council is included.